Hi, welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Jasmine and I have here with me Dinesh Durai from FoodHub. Hi Dinesh, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for hosting me today.
Tell us about FoodHub.
Okay. FoodHub basically is a portal where consumers can able to place order at convenience. And we have the restaurants and the takeaway owners who can process the order with 0% commission.
Okay, 0% commission, wow, that's amazing. And do you have global presence?
Yeah, we are headquartered in the UK and we spread our footprints in Australia, New Zealand, Ireland, and we beefed up into USA and Canada. And we are planning to move to 30 countries in 2 years time frame.
Amazing, that's quite ambitious, but that sounds amazing. Now, what are challenges in this business?
Okay, so the key challenge for this business is speed, right? So we have a hungry consumer wants to place an order, and we have the restaurant owners who needs to process the order in a faster manner to serve the needs of the end consumers. So overall, speed and reliability is the two key factors for us.
Okay, got it. And what are different key features that you would call out as part of this architecture?
Okay, so the key features what we have is we have our EPOS systems, which is hold at the restaurant, restaurant owners will hold it, and where they'll start processing. Predominantly, we have two key use cases. One is the consumer ordering. So when a hungry customer wants to place an order, it's served via CloudFront and S3 at this point. So today for the discussion, let me walk you across the restaurant owner processing an order.
Okay.
Right? So basically, once the order comes in, there are, we have the Amplify SDK, which has been set in all our EPOS machines, and where we could able to get it. Predominantly what happens is, a typical restaurant has different cuisines. You might have a pizza section, a kebab section, and the drink section, right? So orders which is coming in needs to be synced across the devices so that they could able to start processing. Okay. So we have inbuilt all the Amplify SDK into the EPOS machines. And to power this order syncing, we use Appsync, which provides us, in terms of getting in all the syncing across the devices. And that ends, even if, for example, we are dealing with semi-technical people, right? Mm-hmm. Even one machine is unplugged, the operation stops. So what we want to do is we want to ensure that all the EPOS machines are up to date at any time and any point of time. So we leverage AppSync based on that. And what we have, we use a lot of Lambda resolvers. So basically for order syncing and notifications, dashboarding. So Lambda resolvers helps us a lot, and it helps us during scale as well. And what we also do is based on the Lambda, in the past we use Aurora as our database. Now we moved into DynamoDB. So what DynamoDB is gives us a length and breadth of services what it has. And with AWS managed services, it helps us to scale during a peak period.
Okay, great. And I see this is serverless architecture. So how does that help you in scaling as well as reducing your operational overhead?
Okay. So predominantly, most of the order placements happens on a weekend, for example. We also do on a weekend, right? On a Friday, say between 5 to 7 is a peak period, right? So where the orders are getting placed by consumers. And same way, the clients, the restaurant owners needs to process those orders fast. Right, so with AWS managed services, we could able to scale in breadth and length, and we can able to maintain the concept of speed.
Great. So basically, on weekends you might see spikes, right? And these are not gradual increase of orders, but a spike in particular period, right? And that's where something like DynamoDB helps you, which is a NoSQL database, right? And amazing that this is completely serverless. That's great. Now, coming to the insights that the restaurant owners need in terms of any metrics. So, how do you take care of that?
Okay. So, predominantly, what happens in the day, the restaurant owners wants to process the orders. So they want to look at the stats and before closing the shop so that they know what they have got and how much they earned and so on and so forth, right? So where insights becomes a key component for them. And what we do is from the DynamoDB streams, we pass us the data to the Kinesis, so where it can manage the state. And from Kinesis, we push to S3. So S3 is our data lake at this point, where we store all the data, and we run ETLs over it, and we start computing the data. So in the end of the day, right, see, predominantly all the restaurants closes at 11 p.m. and everybody wants to see the stats, and you can assume the volume. We have around 28,000 plus restaurants who might eat at the same time.
Wow.
So thus, we serve it from S3, and we use QuickSight as our predominant dashboarding tool, where we could able to see it. Not only the restaurant owners, the internal back office people wants to know how the restaurants is fared today, or probably should I do some campaigns for them.
Mm-hmm.
So for all those insights, S3 QuickSight provides us a lot of insight, and you know, we could able to manure the data and take data driven decisions.
That's amazing. So twofold, right? One is looking at the current state, how does it look like in terms of dashboard reports for restaurants?
Yeah.
And another is also giving them intelligent insight in terms of what can they do better.
Yeah.
Right? Amazing. And so Kinesis, do you use this for real-time insights?
Yeah, so in the past, this was one of the biggest challenge, right? We used to provide the data end of the day. So now with Kinesis, we could able to provide real-time data, real-time insights. So thus we use Kinesis streams plunked into S3. From there, we query through QuickSight.
Wow, so what could be better than getting real-time insights, right, for restaurant owners?
Yeah.
That's quite a...
So predominantly real-time, right? When we go into franchise, right, so the franchise owner at the top wants to see how this franchise are faring.
Mm-hmm.
So this solution provides them to do a real-time data analysis and see which rest takeaway is doing better, which is not doing, so that what marketing campaign you can change. So those data-driven decisions are taken at length and breadth.
Got it. That's great. And what's the volume of orders that we're talking about here?
Okay, in an average peak day, say we used to get a concurrency of, during a peak time, 300 orders per minute.
Okay.
And if you take in the past, we have processed 23 million orders in 2020, and last year we processed 63 million, and we're keeping our fingers crossed to cross that mark.
Wow, 63 million orders in 2021, that's quite a number. Thank you for sharing this architecture with us, and thanks for watching This Is My Architecture.